Most important thing to keep in mind during diet. How do you stay motivated? Do you work out when you're on your period? What is your MBTI? Hey guys! So, today's video is a bit different. I'm speaking English! Yay! No! So a lot of you guys asked for a video of me speaking English full time. So at first I was just gonna film a vlog, but I figured it'd be a completely silent vlog of me not knowing what to do with my mouth shut. So that's a no-go. But I still didn't want to pressure myself into doing something fancy. So I've decided to film a casual sit-down chit-chat video and jazz it up a little with some Q&As. Before going in, a little disclaimer. I am not a native English speaker whatsoever. So this video is going to be super awkward and cringy, but bear with me. And please, spare me any hate comments about my English being this or that. Cause I was born and raised in Korea. I speak fluent Korean. And English is more like a little something on the side. You know what I mean? It's a hobby. It's supposed to be fun. So keep that in mind, but nevertheless, I will give you my best shot. Anywho, enough jabbering, let's just give it a go. And enjoy seeing me failing miserably. So, here goes nothing. First question, how old are you? I'm 28 in Korean age and 26 in international age. Korea has this weird age counting system that no one else in the world uses. So Korean age and just normal age differs by a year or two. I was born in October 1st, 1994, so you can sort of count my age based on that. Would you recommend someone who is under 16 to go on a diet? What? No girl, nope. Go study, stay in school, eat, and exercise, but don't go on a diet. If it's a healthy one, then maybe, yeah. But the fact is, a lot of the girls that age go for a really extreme diet by starving themselves without any proper exercise. Doing so will ruin your metabolism going forward. So please don't do that to yourself. I never did it and I turned out fine. What is your height? I'm 162 in centimeter and 5'3 in foot or feet. Don't know which is correct. Do you eat snack when you're on diet? When I was on a diet? Nope. When I'm on the maintenance mode, which is right now, then yes, very much yes. Most important thing to keep in mind during diet. It's a thinker. Do it for the right reason. So many of the girls in my comments say they want to lose weight because their boyfriend said they're fat. Or their friends are avoiding them, which sucks, I know. I mean, they suck. Cut them out of your life. Once you start your diet, you have to maintain it for the rest of your life. Literally, you have to do it forever. And if the reason for your diet is someone or something other than yourself, you won't last, I guarantee you. So be your own role model and aim for better you in the future for you. Don't seek for others' approval. That was a lot of pep talk, but I think that's the key in diet. Can diet without exercise achieve dream body? I can't define what dream body is here, but I'm going to make an educated guess and say that you mean Instagram, hourglass, basically unrealistic body. Correct me if I'm wrong, but you do know that a lot of those influencers get all kinds of surgeries and injections to achieve their ridiculously curvaceous body. Even though they do a lot of other stuff to make their body happen, what holds them together is muscle, which can only be made by working out. For me, I just want a healthy body with just the right amount of fat and muscles. And to achieve my definition of dream body, working out is also a must. You can avoid it. If you starve yourself to lose weight without any workout, not only is it deeply unhealthy, but also your body is literally going to melt down. Your skin will lose all the elasticity and it'll all be just dripping down from your body. You can't skip exercise if you want that youthful, elastic, strong body. You simply have to work out. What is your motivation to exercise and diet every day? What does motivate you? How do you stay motivated? What was your first motivation for losing weight? This is the most highly, frequently asked question. How do I stay motivated? It's really hard to pinpoint. Well, at first I was motivated by my doctor to lose weight, or else I was soon to have diabetes and spend the rest of my life in excruciating pain. What a great news! How exciting!
Well, no thank you.
And what really got me up and running was I watched a documentary about what diabetes can do to a person, and it was horrific. It was a wake-up call for me because, stupidly so, I didn't really get the grasp of the seriousness of this disease. But watching the documentary of people cutting their arms and legs because of the complications caused by diabetes, I just had to lose weight to survive. And now that I've lost a healthy amount of weight and my diabetes is gone, I don't really need any motivation. I am in love with my current body, and I also love all the changes that were made after my diet. And I tend to keep everything this way for a long time. So I think my main motivation is me. I mean, changed me. I know it sounds so tacky and cliche, but it's true. I don't really seek for motivation elsewhere. Moving on, what was your heaviest weight? This is a fun one. I was 70 kilograms, which is around 155 pounds, when I was a senior in high school. I don't know if you guys know this, but senior year of high school in Korea is a battlefield. I slept 3 hours a day and spent the rest of every single second studying, which required a lot of eating to keep me energized and sitting to study. So I gained 20 kilograms in that 1 year. Also, I got stretch marks all over my body thanks to that experience, which I don't mind now, but it took a good decade to fully accept a part of my body. Anywho, if you're a student, don't do anything extreme to your body, cause it gets harder to change your metabolism as you get older. Try not to lose too much, but also try not to gain too much either, like I did. Okay, next one, how to manage sweet cravings. And another one, how to cut sugar intake. Well, my first recommendation is to switch sugars into zero-calorie sweeteners. If you like soda, switch them into Diet Coke, Diet Sprite, and etc. If you like to add sugar to your coffee, try switching it with stevia or allulose. They're just as sweet as sugar, but have zero calorie and don't affect your weight at all. So try to be friends with them. Next. Does stretching really help you tone parts of your body? Yes, it really works, guys. It worked wonders for my body, and I've seen so many positive comments saying that following my stretching routine changed their life. Vindicated! If you want to see how much of a difference a simple stretching can make to your body, come check out my How to Lose Thigh Fat video. No shame. Not a question, but your videos always make me so happy! Stop it! You watching my videos make me happy! Thank you! Goal of the year. Bucket list. The very first thing I want to do this year is to learn Spanish. Español. Right now, I can speak Korean, obviously, a little bit of English, and a little bit of Chinese. But my goal in life is to learn 6 languages before I die. And the fourth one on the list is Spanish. I actually tried learning it last year. I bought all the books and paid for the class and everything. And as I expected, I got lazy and totally blew my money. But this year is gonna be different. So wish me luck! Other than Spanish, there are several more things on my list, which are, of course, workout, eat healthy, go on a road trip every quarter. Huh. Make a new productive hobby, save money, which I'm so bad at, spend less than $1,000 a month, which I'm failing already, throw away stuff that I don't use anymore. I'm a hoarder, so this one I really gotta stick to. Only meet with the people that I actually wanna meet. Like, don't force myself to meet or keep in touch with the people that I'm not comfortable. I used to do that a lot when I was young, cause I thought having as many friends as possible was the most important thing in life. But I now know it isn't. Now I want to keep my social life as small and intimate as possible. And last but not least, try something new with my career, which is very ambiguous and I don't have any plans yet. But I just want to challenge myself into doing something completely new this year. And if I get to have any ideas, you guys will be the first ones to know. What's your favorite place to eat out? Favorite restaurant in Seoul? If you've been following my vlogs, then you probably know that I hate cooking. I always order food. Before COVID, I used to eat out every single day. So there are so many of my favorite places that pops in my head. But gun to my head, I'd say Austria Semkim. Well, pasta is my favorite food to begin with, and they make the best pasta that I've ever tried in my life. And I just went there recently to celebrate me reaching 50k subscribers! Yay! It's actually 60k now. What? What? Oh! So yeah, what was I saying? They didn't disappoint me. If you're ever in Korea, I highly recommend giving this place a try. Their chef is really famous in Korea, and for a good reason. Do you work out when you're on your period? No, I don't even lift a finger when I'm on a period. I get very moody and in general bitchy when I'm on a period, so I can't bother myself with working out. I eat whatever I want when I'm on a period and work out when it's over. That's my coping mechanism to deal with that little biatch inside me. What job do you do? I'm working at a cosmetics brand in Korea, and I'm a team manager of our brand's global business team. And our main job is to sell our products to overseas customers. Simple as that. So we do have a lot of work, but I've been doing the same job for almost 4 years now, and I still really enjoy it. Following that question, will you ever quit working and just do YouTube as a job? So many of you asked me about this, and my answer for now is nope. Because like I said, I'm a manager of our team, so there are many people on my team that are counting on me, and just a lot of responsibilities lie on my shoulder. So even though I love doing YouTube, and I'm having so much fun hanging out with you guys, but I can't just quit. And besides all that, I just enjoy seeing our brand, our company, grow so much so fast. And it's a rare opportunity to work at a place that has so much potential and so much to offer, which makes me very thankful for this job. And my teammates are just the bomb. I'm just not ready to let go of any of it yet. But I don't think I'll be in a while. Do you have a favorite clothing brand? I love Polo Ralph Lauren, but I can't buy them that often because they're hella expensive. What is your MBTI? A lot of my Korean viewers ask me this question, but I never really answered it because it changes a lot. But so far, the most frequent one that pops up is ESFJ. So I'm an extrovert, relies on senses, empathize well, and plan-oriented. The second highest one is ISFJ. So everything else is pretty much the same, but I'm 51% extrovert and 49% introvert. So I'm right in the middle. Many of you think that I'm super duper outgoing and have lots and lots of friends, but not really. I like being alone, and I have a very small group of friends. Tiny. I may show as an extrovert to other people, but deep inside, I enjoy being an introvert. I think that's about it. I did miss a lot of other questions, but I don't want this video to be too long. So I'm so sorry if I didn't answer yours, but I will do another Q&A in the future. Thank you so much if you came this far. You are the best. I thought I was getting anxiety filming this video, but weirdly so, I kinda enjoyed it. I hope you guys did too. And if you didn't, I'm sorry. Anyhow, that's it for this video. Comment down below if you have any more questions, and I will hopefully see you guys on the next one.